Alright, so today on Windows XP Bootcamp, in the first episode, I'm going to show you how to keep your Windows XP safe and secure. Because obviously with all the malware that's running around now, Windows XP, in fact, it's not in your update, you'll probably want some, you know, you'll probably want to keep it secure. The first thing, obviously, to do to keep it secure is go ahead, Windows Update. Since there's been a new security update that's only just rolled around, you'll want to check this because it's quite a vital security update, and like I said, literally just got updated not too long ago. Just quick express and it'll check for updates and install them. Now you might need a new version of Internet Explorer to do this, but chances are if you've got Windows XP on your old PC, you've probably kept it up to date anyway. So while that's checking, I'll show you some other things you can do to keep it secure. Now the biggest and probably most important thing you can do to get secure is ditch Internet Explorer. The browser's out of date and frankly probably doesn't even work with most sites anyway. So you'll just obviously want to hop over to Google, like so. Well, you all know how to go to Google, obviously. Punch in your Firefox. Now this is probably the best browser to get on XP. And it'll be supported till later on this year, I believe. After that point, it will obviously still continue to work, but presumably there's some other browsers that will continue to support it after that. Some slightly more obscure ones, presumably. So you just want to grab yourself a copy of this. And it won't take too long to download, hopefully. Like I say, once that's finished done, run it. Now make sure you're downloading the ESR download, that's the extended support release, which will be supported till the end this year. If you wanted something more cutting edge, you presumably could get it, but I wouldn't recommend it on account of the fact you'll be getting security updates. So you just want to go ahead and install that. Let's see how the update's doing. Yep. Now you want to install everything here. It's all important. So you just want to install updates. Yeah, you know how to install updates, obviously. You want to launch a Firefox. Now, like I say, make sure all the updates are downloading. And there you go. You've got an up-to-date browser, which should presumably work better with most websites. Not only that, be more secure. The next thing I would recommend you should probably do is get yourself a script blocker. Now, most malware gets through, obviously, great, like most drive-by attacks anyway. So you want to install this is the one you want. Go ahead and install it, restart now, and when it comes up you might notice something. Got this in the corner here, but not only that, if we pop over to Google, you'll notice it's displaying slightly differently. Well, actually it doesn't look too different here, but you'll notice you don't get suggested results because the script has been blocked, as you can see. So for example, an internet game, Cookie Clicker. Oh, well, just search a cookie, but you understand the idea. Cookie Clicker, which is a relatively script-heavy game that doesn't use Flash, which, by the way, that's a big piece of advice. If you have Flash on your computer, you'll probably want to get rid of it. As you can see, you've got the updates there. Because Flash is basically insecure as anything. But as you can see, it's not loading because these scripts are blocked. So what do you want to do if you want to see scripts? Because this actually will probably break compatibility with blocked sites. Well, if you know the site is secure, just go ahead and click on this. And click allow the site. And when we reload, let's see, working perfectly fine. The same principle will probably apply to sites like Facebook and that as well. As you can say, we've got all the new security updates there. The next thing you'll want to do, quite obviously, get yourself an antivirus. Me personally, I find the best one to be Avast, or Avast, if you prefer. You want to just get yourself a copy of that. Now that will most likely, block out like a lot of malware you're going to get, basically. Grab yourself a copy of this. I would ignore that, but if you get that, that's just proof your script blocker is working, which is what you want. Go ahead and wait for that to install. I'll be back when it does. Oh, and in case you didn't know, literally you don't need to click customize, just hit install and it'll go ahead and install it for you. Simple as that. Right, there we go, we got the Avast installed. Go ahead and just click continue on that. Wouldn't worry about that. And here you go, your Avast. Now this here, I'm sure it run on your computer and keep you safe from most viruses and ransomware. With the script locker combined with that and the new update that's come out, you should be pretty much good to go. The next thing I would say though, make sure you keep a backup of your files in case anything does happen. If anything does happen and you've got your files backed up, simple stuff, reinstall XP, do all this again, put your files back on, and you're up and running again. No messing around, no getting the files back. If it's ransomware, you don't have to pay anything because, you know, your files are up to the cloud. I recommend you go with Google Drive or something along those lines. Bear in mind, if you do want to use Google Drive, more likely than not, you'll have to disable your script blocker on Google Drive. If I assume you do. But yeah, as you can see, everything's up and running. Now the next thing I recommend you do, get yourself a copy of Malwarebytes as well as Avast. Now the free version, or Malwarebytes, or the free version at least, is more of a malware scanner as opposed to an antivirus. And I find the detection rate, also to get it you'll have to allow Malwarebytes.com, the detection rate I find to be slightly better than, say, Avast, and it detects different things as well. So basically, if something slipped through your Avast, scan with Malwarebytes every so often, and that should hopefully pick it up. And, like I said, Malwarebytes is a simple install, just download it, run it. You get a free trial of the premium version as well, which is an antivirus which does run at real time, so obviously you can use that. And with all those in mind, pretty much the best you can do to keep your Windows XP secure.